Scientists solve mystery of very rare blood clots linked to adenovirus COVID vaccines. A type of COVID-19 vaccine has been linked to rare blood clots. This urged many experts to investigate the cause. Recently, a research group discovered the potential reason behind it. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. Led by the Arizona State University and Cardiff University, researchers examined how these blood clots came to be in some vaccinated with adenovirus-based COVID-19 vaccines. Keep in mind that the benefits from these vaccines still outweigh the risks, especially those from COVID-19. The rare blood clot associated with these vaccines is called vaccine-induced immune thrombotic thrombocytopenia, or VITT. According to ASU researchers, it is a rare, life-threatening condition reported in a small number of recipients of AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson vaccines. To know the culprit of VITT, they studied the structural biology and molecular details of the vaccine. They use ASU's new cryo-EM facilities and the Titan Cryos machine. With these, they successfully observed the AstraZeneca vaccine in action. One of the things they looked at was the viral vector utilized by the vaccines. If you don't know, both vaccines required a vector, adenovirus in this case, to carry the much-needed part to trigger an immune response. Published in Science Advances, their findings suggest that the viral vector might be related to the rare side effect. The viral vector might enter the bloodstream and bind to platelet factor 4 or PF4. If these two bind together, the immune system would see the new complex as foreign. As a response, the immune system would release antibodies. The antibodies then bind and activate the platelets. This would cause the platelets to clump up, leading to blood clots in a small number of people who receive either vaccine. It's really critical to fully investigate the vector-host interactions of the vaccine at a mechanistic level, said ASU corresponding author Abhishek Singh Roy. Corresponding author Alan Parker of Cardiff University clarified that VITT only happens in extremely rare cases. Whatever side effect it may be, experts always remind the public to contact their healthcare provider if they feel anything weird after vaccination. What do you think about the new discovery? Do you believe their findings may lead to specific VITT treatments? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.